Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about how the reaction takes place between the ammonia along with that of the alkyl halide. And now we are going to talk about that what is the reaction between the alkyl halide along with that of sodium alkoxide. So let us talk about it. So basically an alkyl halide is been treated with that of sodium alkoxide so as to obtain ether. And this kind of synthesis of ether is basically known as Williamson synthesis of ether. And this is what we are going to talk about. So now let me explain about that is how this sodium alkoxide is being treated with that is alkyl halide so as to obtain that is ether. So let us talk about the general reaction first. So talking about the reaction, that is when alkyl halide is being treated with that of that is sodium alkoxide, that is suppose if I am mentioning over here as, and now here I have represented that is R dash. It means that the both the alkyl groups can be same also, can be different also. But let me just go through this reaction first. So the thing is, we have to boil these two solutions in such a manner that is one of the sodium that is I am mentioning over here. So that would be able to remove this halogen atom in the form of that is sodium salt, that is NaX. And the remaining part is basically ROR dash. So this is what we have got over here. And again, this is a kind of a substitution reaction in which basically the halogen atom of the alkyl halide is been replaced by the alkoxy group. And here, this is basically the alkoxy group that we have. So this reaction is basically the one that is forming ether. And this kind of reaction that is what we have formed over here is basically known as Williamson synthesis of ether, and this is what we have got over here. So now let us talk about the examples related to this, but this is the generation that we have to consider, and because of which we could be able to form various kind of ethers, and because we know that ethers are been substituted into various parts, that is it can be simple ether also as well as it can be that is a complex or mixed ether also. So now let me give you the example of this too, and we'll be able to find out that how the question would come and how can we tackle this kind of questions. For an example, suppose if we have that is CH3Br suppose, and if we are reacting with that is sodium alkoxide, suppose in this case, suppose if I am considering that is sodium methoxide. So this is what we have, and again suppose if these two solutions are being boiled in such a manner that is Na along with that of Br is being removed in the form of that is NaBr. Then the thing that is left is basically CH3OCH3. So this is what it is left, and talking about the name of this one, so let me introduce the common name for this one also. That is the common name, because the both of the groups are basically the same, so therefore it could be called as across the oxygen atom, it's basically methyl groups. So therefore the name of this one could be called as dimethyl ether. So that is a common name that we have discussed over here right now. And now let us talk about the IUPAC name. The IUPAC name of this kind of that is molecule that we have obtained over here is basically it is known as methoxymethane. So this is what we have got over here, and this is basically known as simple ether. The reason behind, or we could also call it as symmetrical ether. So because the both of that is the group that are been attached across the oxygen atoms are basically the same, and hence it is known as simple ether. And now let us talk about suppose what happens if we are treating that is methyl bromide with that of the other alkoxide. Suppose methyl bromide is been treated with that is sodium ethoxide. So again a substitution reaction would take place over here, and it is very easy to understand. So we could write it over here as that is this NaBr, it will be removed over here like I'm writing over here. And the product that we could get over here is basically CH3OC2H5. And this is basically an example of an mixed ether. And this is what I could say, that is, there are two different groups that are been attached across the oxygen atom over here. That is, one is methyl group, while the other one is ethyl. So the common name of this one would be given as, because let us understand the IUPAC nomenclature for this one also, as well as the common name. So here, basically, the name of this one would be basically ethyl, methyl, ether. Again, an alphabetical order that we have to follow. So therefore, the name of this one would be ethyl, methyl, ether when it comes to the common name. But while talking about that is the IUPAC, since the smaller group is basically CH3 compared to that of the C2H5, so this one will have associated with this of oxygen atom according to the IUPAC name. So therefore, the name of this one would be methoxyethane. So this is what we have got over here, and this is basically Williamson's synthesis of ether, or the reaction of alkyl halide with that of sodium alkoxide. So now let me give you a few questions related to this also, and let's see that how we are able to solve this kind of question that I am going to talk about. So this is the question that we are going to solve. That is, the question is, that is, how can you obtain, that is, 2-methoxypropane from isopropyl chloride? So we have to obtain basically an ether, and when it comes to the preparation of ether, that is from an alkyl halide, it is basically Williamson synthesis. So this is what we are going to talk about, and what we have to do is, we have to prepare an ether from isopropyl chloride. So let us draw the structure of isopropyl chloride. So this is the structure of isopropyl chloride, and again, what we have to do is, we have to obtain basically an ether. So let us understand this thing, that is, the ether that we have to obtain over here is basically 2-methoxypropane. So we could write the structure of that as this one, that is. So let's talk about the methoxy group. So methoxy group can be written as, that is, CH3O. While talking about the propane should consist of basically three carbon atoms. But the thing is, it has been mentioned as 2-methoxypropane. That's the reason that we can't attach that is the methoxy group to the primary carbon atom. So that's the reason that obviously we have to attach this methoxy group to the secondary carbon atom, and that could be written, or that could be mentioned in this way, that is. And now this is basically the secondary carbon atom over here, because this carbon atom is attached to two carbon atoms over here. And now while talking about that is the IUPAC name, then the structure is very much similar to this one. That is, if this is the first carbon atom, second carbon atom, and the third carbon atom according to IUPAC name, IUPAC rules. So therefore, on the second carbon atom, the methoxy group is present. So this is what we have. But talking about the reagent, and because we know that alkoxide is the one that should be used, but as we can see over here, that is the total number of four carbon atoms in the product side. That is 1, 2, 3, and 4, and out of which we have mentioned the three carbon atoms that have been mentioned in the reactant. So that's the reason that we have to use only one carbon atom containing alkoxide, and that is nothing but that is sodium methoxide. So whenever the sodium methoxide has been treated with that is of isopropyl chloride, we could say that is a this sodium along with that of this Cl that would be liberated in the form of, or that would be removed in the form of, that is NaCl, and the only thing that is left out is the product that we have. So this is how we can solve this kind of questions, and obviously this is this could create so much of complexity unless we understand this whole concept behind what is Williamson synthesis. So this is what we have, and this is how we can obtain 2-methoxypropane from isopropyl chloride. So this was first question that I was talking about, and now let us move on to the next question, and that is, how can you prepare diethyl ether from an alkyl halide? So the thing is, we have to mention it very clearly that we need basically diethyl ether. So therefore, that could be written in the form of, that is, C2H5O C2H5. So the name that has been given to us is basically a common name, but we can also name it according to the IUPAC name. So therefore, the name of the structure that we have, that is diethyl ether, it could be also given the name as, that is, ethoxyethane. So this is what we will get from an alkyl halide, but we have to make sure for to ourselves, that is, Among this, that is C2H5 and OC2H5. Among this, one would be basically the alkyl halide. So we could say that is C2H5O. This would be belonging to the alkoxide, while the rest of the remaining, that is C2H5, that would be belonging to the alkyl halide. So therefore, we could easily say that is C2H5ClBr or iodine, anyone we could consider, but because the question has been given in that format. So suppose if I am considering that is bromine in this way. So that is ethyl bromide. When ethyl bromide should react with alkoxide, and that alkoxide should consist of two carbons. The reason behind that is because here the total number of carbon that has been present in the product side is basically 4. And what we have mentioned over here as an alkyl halide is basically we have mentioned over here as that is 2 carbon atoms. So the thing is, we have to mention 2 carbon atoms more that should be present in the alkoxide. So therefore, we could write it as C2H5ONA, that is sodium ethoxide. And the reaction is very much simple to understand. That is, this sodium along with that of this bromine atom that would be removed in the form of that is NaBr salt. And this is the product that we have. So this is the product that we have, but we have to choose the reactants very wisely. The reason behind that is, suppose if we consider that is the total number of carbon that has been present in the product side is basically 4. And if we consider that the alkyl halide that we should take, it should consist of 3 carbon atoms, while the alkoxide, it should consist of only 1 carbon atom. But that will not give us the desired product that we need now. So suppose if, for an example, suppose if we have considered that is propyl bromide and we have reacted it with the methoxide, that is sodium methoxide. So again, we could say that the reaction would happen, and obviously we'll get a ether which will consist of 4 carbon atoms and 1 oxygen atom. But that will not make us sure that this will give us the product. So whenever we take that is propyl bromide and we will react it with that of that is sodium methoxide, we'll get an unsymmetrical ether, or basically we'll get a mixed ether. But here the thing is, we are getting a simple ether. So that's the reason that we are choosing wisely what is the alkyl halide. So this was the thing that I was talking about. So that's it. This is what I want to talk about the Williamson synthesis of ether, or we could say that is what is the reaction between the alkyl halide and the sodium alkoxide. So that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know various concepts behind this one. And I hope you'll share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.